Hello guys and welcome back to Yehuda Aquatics. So today we're going to talk about a very meaningful fish for me because this is the first fish I ever got. And today we're going to talk about none other than the guppy. So these fish are actually great for beginners because they don't get that big, they're very hardy, they're colorful, easy to take care of, and easy to breed. Now, you want to keep them in around a 5-gallon tank because for every 2 gallons, you could put one guppy. So let's say you have a 10-gallon tank, you have 5 guppies. So when you buy guppies, you want to know what's your goal. If you want to have babies, then you should get a male and female in ratio of 1 to 2, one male per 2 females. And they will breed because it's just really easy to breed. So when you want to think of males are usually smaller and more colorful while females are bigger and a bit more dull. But also you can tell the difference between them with their anal fin. They have a different shape of anal fin. So in the size difference, males get between 0.6 and 1.4 inches while females get 1.2 to 2.4 inches. Guppies are also known as the million fish because there are just so many types. There's over 300 types of guppies out there. So the guppy fish originally comes from South America, but it could be found all around the world because people pretty much brought it from South America into other parts of the world in order to eat mosquito larvae because that's a thing they eat and to reduce the amount of malaria. The thing is, they reproduced a lot and they became invasive species and started hurting the other populations of fish in those places of the world. So this fish is a live bearer, which means it actually gives birth to the children straight instead of laying eggs. So if you want to breed these, you want to get them in a ratio of 1 male per 2 females. Now, there's a few ways to do this because they may eat their babies. So, or you can separate the mother and let in a different tank. I usually do not like using a breeder's net just because it'll stress them out. And letting her breed there. The second she has babies, take her out. Or you can let them just have the babies in the main tank and just separate them. But you always not want to keep the babies with the parent guppies because they will be eaten. So how do you know when your guppy's pregnant? So first of all, she will get fatter. Also, she has a little dot by her anal fin. She'll get darker, even become black. And it takes around a month till she has babies. And then it takes around 3 to 5 months till they can tell their gender and they reach maturity. And when feeding them, their main diet should be flakes. But I personally feed them flakes and also I sometimes put in their bloodworms just for the other fish in the tank. And they eat bloodworms also. I want to keep them in temperatures between 75 and 82 degrees. Now when you're finding tank mate for these guys, you don't want to put them anything too aggressive or anything too big that will eat them. Because they're really peaceful fish. I personally keep them with corydoras, a betta fish, some neon tetras, shrimp, and even snails. And they get along just great.